my name is Justin DeRoy, and you tune in for a brand new episode of Hi-Fi's Brain Dump. All right, so starting off today, we're going to go over some business news. Apparently, several brewing companies are planning a joint effort to lobby to put cannabis into their beers and hope it'll sway consumers that have been favoring more towards getting high rather than getting buzzed. This is an interesting idea to me. I'm not particularly, big on either drinking, and I really don't even do recreational drugs, period. But it's an interesting business tactic, though, to try and get in on, all this, legalization of marijuana business by trying to add in cannabis into your beer so that you can try and bring over so that 420 crowd. I kind of could see this working out for them well, but really, I don't think a lot of people I don't think people are going to feel like they're going to get as much out of it from drinking cannabis as they do from, smoking it or taking edibles. It really, maybe, for all I know, it might be about the same to them. Again, I'm not part of that crowd. I think it's interesting, but I just don't feel like it's going to work out for them as well as they think it will. Because I don't know, they're going to have some amazing marketing campaign to really draw in this crowd to make them think that would be cool. I can get my buzz on and get it my high. I don't know. Again, I'm saying this from outside perspective because I don't really drink or get high. But yeah, that's really all I had though to say on this subject. So we're going to go ahead and now move on to our tech news topic of the day, which is about Boeing has recently finished their development on the first unmanned fighter jets that are being said to actually very soon be utilized in the Air Force. They said mostly right now, it's mostly the use is going to be just for scouting missions to be able to scout ahead for the manned fighter pilots. So that way they would be able to have someone unmanned go behind enemy territory, scout the area for them, be able to figure out where the enemy targets are. So that way they'll know exactly where to hit once they set in. They're actual human in pilots. This sounds a little disturbing to me just because I think it's only a matter of time before they decide, though, just to mount some guns on these and just send them in there or to just go ahead and, take out what their unmanned fire pilot it's deemed to be enemy threats using a bunch of, algorithms and statistics that tell them that, those must be Taliban. We're going to take them out. It kind of reminds me of something where they talk about Oates in the film RoboCop, where they say, I'd rather have a human making that conscious decision to take away someone's life. This sounds like we're heading straight for Skynet and end times. And I'm not really entirely cool with that. Now, I do like the idea of using this drone technology and so like that, and unmanned aircrafts, but completely unmanned without anyone behind the wheel controlling it, making its decisions, seems scary to me. Now, if we have these used more for just, pilots that are controlling them, remotely and stuff like that, that sounds perfectly fine to me. Because at least you still have someone making a human behind the wheel making those conscious decisions on who's our enemy and who's not. And I just feel like just putting in the hands of a machine that, might make some kind of statistical error and see a wife and child thinking it looks like they have weapons on them and then takes out somebody who's innocent. Or in the process, doesn't think about the innocent lives that are in the area of someone who could be deemed, a threat. And then that way, for collateral damage, be taking out innocent lives. It's just the machine's not going to think about those things. A human being can. Yeah, I'm not entirely behind them trying to completely remove, like, the human equation. But like I said, it's not even being said in this article that I read about this that that's going to happen yet. I just feel like somebody's going to get the idea eventually to probably think about doing this. And I just hope that they think better of not doing it. But enough of this topic. Let's finally move on to some lighter news in the realm of media. So, in recent years, following actually the release of Django Unchained, Quentin Tarantino had come out with this interesting comic book series that's about Django kind of moving out to the West now to continue bounty hunting due to the fact that obviously he's one of men in the East Coast. And along his journeys now of working out in the West Coast actually comes across Zorro, you know, the famed, you know, kind of Mexican hero, and end up teaming up together to help not only save, you know, Zorro's people, but also help save slaves in the West. So the idea is, though, that now this comic book that Quentin Tarantino created is being shopped around to possibly be made into actually a movie. And to be honest, this sounds like it'd be awesome to me. Two different franchises I absolutely love. Django Chain is easily one of my favorite Quentin Tarantino movies I've seen in a while. And Zorro, I love Zorro. I remember I watched, you know, the original old, some of the original black and white movies. There's a cartoon series I was a big fan of. Of course, then we have the Antonio Banderas, like, kind of like modern day reboot they came out with that I always enjoyed. So especially since I even heard people rumoring like how great it would be if they can get him back. I don't know about that happening. He might be a little too old for that. Even though this Zorro in the comic book series right here is supposed to be older, more like, you know, grizzled kind of Zorro. So it's not out of the realm of possibility of, you know, him being part of this franchise if they do it. But, yeah, I'd totally be on board with this, especially if also the rumors could be true that this could be Quentin Tarantino's next project after, you know, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. It feels like it'd be a weird movie for him to go out on since he's supposedly going to retire after he finishes his 10th film. But yeah, I'd still, even if he doesn't do it, I'd think this sounds great. I'd really love to see this happen. So I'm really rooting for this. But I think I'll go ahead and end it on that. I would definitely like to thank you all for tuning in. Be sure to like, share, comment, subscribe. Maybe also check out the Patreon link we have in the description below. Plus, we have other content on the channel I'd like you to check out, such as on Tuesday, me and my brother do a High Five Pop. And Wednesday, I have my Canceled Misfits. So I'd love you to check out either one of those shows. But, yep, that's going to be it for me today. Thanks again for tuning in. Goodbye.